There's no easy way to say this. 7 more Blockbusters just closed. You're officially the last one on Earth.
I don't love the pattern that's starting to emerge. Hello?
Come on, I'm the last man standing.
How am I supposed to be the next Tarantino if I don't work in a video store?
Uh-huh. Yeah, that's what's holding you back.
No one's going anywhere because everything is under control.
That's reassuring.
Just act like one of your favorite bosses from a movie.
Like Boss Baby or Devil's Advocate?
One of those is a baby and one is Satan.
And look at the heights they reach despite their circumstances.
Fair.
But Timmy, this focus, I think we're gonna be okay.
An eviction notice?
I felt real bad about it. That's why I drew a sad face on it.
No one takes me seriously. I've been working here since the 7th grade.
That is not the flex you think it is.
I've always thought of myself as over 40 at heart. I don't get why you're getting a degree in accounting. All you do is talk about making movies.
Accounting is basically like the film of numbers. See?
That was the saddest thing I've ever said.
Saddest thing I've ever said is one ticket for Space Jam 2.
Sorry if I haven't seemed stoked to be suddenly working the same job I had in high school, just so I can afford the studio apartment I had to rent because I caught my husband Aaron on a date with a 25-year-old, also named Aaron.
Why is that worse?
I don't know, but it is. The last miss.
I put everything I had into this store. Because it's the only place that's ever felt like home.
Blockbuster on 3!
Just so you know, I am aware of your feelings towards Eliza.
I mean, are you like picking up a vibe or something, love?
This is so fun.
This calls for another drink.
You're a business owner. You did the whole 30 twice. And you smell good. Timmy, you are in your prime right now.
Yeah, what's it like living such a dream?
Well, you know, it has its ups and downs.
Don't fall for it.
It's sarcasm.
She almost got you.
Come on, man. The next man standing.
Boom, there you go. That was the trailer for Blockbuster arriving to Netflix on November 3rd. I am Kuya P. This is Nerds Rule the World. And as you see on the screen, special guest Randall Park, a.k.a. Timmy Yoon. I'm so excited. I'm going to shoot off air horns right now. You don't hear it. It's thank you for your
nice
time,
I
Randall.
I hear it. Yep, sounds good.
Truly a pleasure. This series, I really enjoyed it. I had a chance to watch it in advance. It's all about community and the importance of community. Yeah. In a lot of ways. And so I just kind of want to lead off as an Asian American filmmaker and actor. The community is celebrating this win right now because you're in this role and you're redefining us as Asian Americans, especially us as males. So just really love to see it right now.
Oh, brother. Thank you, man. That means a lot. It means
definitely.
A lot.
So with that being said, what would you say is the importance of Timmy Yoon, or what do you hope the reaction from the audience gets from Timmy Yoon and the messaging in the series?
Oh, gosh. Well, I hope the audience gets that, this is a show ultimately about a family, you know, a workplace family, and that there's a lot of love, you know, a lot of love in this family, and it's a diverse family, and there isn't too much commentary on that. It's just kind of naturally what it is. It's our lives, you know, and also what it takes to run a small business in these days and times, and it takes that group effort, you know, it takes that commitment, and it takes that camaraderie, and that's all there. And I think it's a beautiful thing to watch. And I think it's, you know, especially in these days and times, I feel like a show like this is like, you know, it's like a warm hug, you know what I mean? And I feel like a lot of people will hopefully feel that from us.
I love that. And I completely agree. And I think they will. One of the things I really enjoyed seeing is your collaboration with JB Smoove. I really enjoyed that. I can see myself in these characters. Yeah. And I see myself in the relationship you had with JB Smoove, with a close Black friend growing up. So I love that, because a lot of society, and you see that they try to pit Asians and African Americans against each other. I love that this kind of shows that and bridges that, and that it's not there, that we do exist and we are friendly to each other. Can you tell me about working with JB Smoove?
That was never my life. You know, I'm the same as you. I grew up with, you know, my best friends are Black. Just really all races, you know, it's like, I grew up with a very diverse group of friends. So for me, it's like, none of this is weird. You know, it's like, it's very normal, and it's very, you know, I mean, maybe for some people, it's not like what, you know, what they've experienced growing up, but a lot of people grow up, you know, with friends of every background. And you know, when you're growing up, it's not like you don't even like talk about it. It's just what it is. And it's just about your, you know, your lives. And sometimes it may come up, sometimes it won't, you know. So I feel like, you know, really proud to be on a show that showcases that, you know.
Definitely. And I was loving seeing that. And working with JB Smoove, have you cutting up? How was that?
Oh, man. That dude. You know, I worked with him on Fresh Off the Boat. He came and did a few episodes. Yep. And we played really old best friends, college friends on Fresh Off the Boat. So it was, you know, and we had so much fun, and it was just, you know, it was just one of those things. We just have so much fun working together, but also just hanging out. So I just love that guy. And you know, any opportunity to hang out with JB Smoove is a good time.
I love it. I was digging it. Last week, I had the pleasure of having on Stephanie Isaac, who plays Lena.
Oh, Stephanie. I love Stephanie.
She was awesome. And when I saw her come into the role on the series, what I was really excited to see, because we don't get it a lot as Asian Americans, a love triangle. But I'm going to leave it there. I'm not going to spoil. But can you tell me, what did that mean for you? Because I don't know if you've seen it, but it's rare for us to have that. And you got that, man. So I was like, another win. We get a love triangle, an Asian American being like, you know.
Yeah, man. I mean, I think it, just to have like, I mean, I grew up loving rom-coms and just loving love and not seeing us depicted in that context growing up. You know, we'd see ourselves on occasion on screen, but it was never in that context of love, you know. And that's just such a universal human thing, you know, that I feel like for us to, you know, especially nowadays, we're seeing more and more of it. Not just me, but you know, just a lot of great projects where we get to see people who look like us, like falling in love and being in these complicated relationships and being, you know, and I think, I don't know, to me, that's so cool.
Yeah, definitely.
And humanizing, you know.
Yes. Yeah. Well, Randall, I want to thank you for your time. I get to do a lot of interviews as part of this gig, and this has got to be one of my highlights of the year.
Oh, my God.
Kuya P, thank you, man. Filmmaker, actor, you're doing the job that I want to do, and you're doing the roles and redefining what we look like on screen. Oh. So I can't thank you enough.
Thank you, Kuya P. Good talking to you, brother.
Definitely. Y'all, Randall Park, a.k.a. Timmy Yoon, is coming to Blockbuster it's coming to Netflix. Blockbuster, November 3rd. Check it out. 10 episodes. Fun series. You're going to love it. I'm QP. This is Nerds World of the World. Randall Park, y'all. Appreciate you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Right, thanks, talking guys. To you, man. That's tremendous. Pleasure, dude. Oh,